Hello friends, let us see how to use a 4-point DIT FFT graph in solving a problem. Let us consider a problem x of n as equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a 4-point sequence with values given as 1, 2, 3, 4. First of all, I need to break up the sequence. I know the value of n at this point is 0. Value of n at this point is 1, value of n at this point is 2, and over here is 3. Right. So what we are going to do? I'm going to split the even part of n and odd part of n because we are using DIT FFT. So I will use x of 0, I'll put 1. So let us say, use some other color. So this is nothing but 1. Okay, then x of 2 is value is 3, so I'll write here as 3. Then x of 1 is nothing but 2, and x of 3 is nothing but 4. So I'm writing the amplitude value of particular value at particular value of n. Okay, so when n is even, we club them together, and wherever n is odd, we club them together. Now, whenever I go up, I'm going to add. Now this 3 traverse through this line and 1 is coming from here. When they meet at this point, they're going to add. So 3 plus 1 is going to be 4. Whenever it is coming down, this is 1 and this is 3 minus 3 because I'm going to multiply it by minus 1. So 3 into minus 1 is minus 3. Minus 3 added with 1 is minus 2. Then I'm going to get added this as 2 plus 4, which is 6, and 2 plus 4, 2 minus 4, which will give me minus 2 again. Right. Now we are going to multiply. Now here there is no multiplying factor, so I'll write 4 at this node, minus 2 at this node. Here there is a multiplying factor. The multiplying factor is 1, so I use 1 into 6 is 6 back. And here I'm going to multiply minus j with minus 2. I'm going to get 2j. Correct. Now again, whenever I go up, I'm going to add. So I'm going to up, going from here, 4 plus 6 will give me 10. Right. So I'm adding 4 and here is 6. Then I'm going to add 2 and then this is minus 2 and this is plus 2j. So the answer is minus 2 plus 2j. Then we have at x of 2, we are going to subtract. So I'm going to subtract 4 minus 6, which is equal to minus 2. Right. So 4 minus 6 is minus 2. And finally, I'm going to subtract this. So this is minus 2. And this 2j multiplied by minus 1. So this becomes minus 2 minus 2j. So the answer of this factor, that is x of k, is 10 minus 2 plus 2j minus 2 minus 2 minus 2j. Now the viewers are encouraged to solve the same problem using DFT formula and see the answer or check the answer. You will find that the answer that you obtain using this method will be the same as been obtained by the based formula method. But here, the operation really took less time to solve the problem. Only thing is, we need to know the graph. And then we were parallelly computing even and odd sections of the graph. And then combining at this section gives me the final answer. So we have seen that how easy it is to use a FFT method and to actually get the answer quickly compared to the formula-based method of DFT. Thank you.